One of the nicest things about being the MC is that a lot of really remarkable people who I admire tremendously are compelled to interact with me against their will. And I get to meet these remarkable folks.
So
one of the nicest things about being the MC.
This is too many gay code jokes. There's a little bit nasty about some circle jerking before they meet and bondage here, and when he plays with his pointer and make him believe he's coming on top of everybody. It's pretty nasty, this beginning here. And then I'll show you the clip at the end where he blasphemes.
Is that a lot of really remarkable people who I admire tremendously are compelled to interact with me against their will. And I get to meet these remarkable folks. And one of them is our next speaker, Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson. Are you ready? Dr. Tyson is the director of the Hayden Planetarium in New York. And I will tell you, as a former high school planetarium director, the Hayden Planetarium is the big time. We call it the show.
Yeah, the show.
He made books, but I think his most remarkable accomplishment is in the year 2000, People magazine named him the sexiest astrophysicist alive.
That contest was rigged.
Phil Clayton says the contest was rigged. It would not have mattered, Phil. He did ultimately lose out to Brad Pitt, but we are delighted. We think he's a much better keynote speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Well, first of all, I was duly impressed by the number of laser pointers chasing each other at the beginning of this session, and I couldn't have think of something more geeky than that. That was just so. But then I did, actually, because I want to establish my geek credentials in this audience. Will everyone please take out their laser pointer?
Greek.
See the
Greek
arch in the back of the room above the exit sign in the middle. Please touch that region with your lasers. Okay.
You hear that?
I will now touch
you
that
hear
region
everyone laugh?
With my laser.
Watch.
Okay, there we go. All right. So, I would claim, and I'm projecting farther than your lasers, am I not? Okay. Just to establish my geek credential. Well,
yeah.
Until the screen comes up, allow me to make a few comments. Of course you're going to allow it because I'm standing here for this. I have no choice in the matter. First of all, I'm not a professional skeptic. I'm in Psalms. That the rest of that goes, and live in a world of peace, actually. So it associates peace with being meek. That stands to reason because weak people don't bomb cities, okay? So there's a correlation to that fact. But I went back to the original Hebrew. And I studied enough Hebrew to translate this directly, and they mistranslated. They got it wrong. What it really says is, and the geek shall inherit the earth, okay? I'll leave you with one slide. The American Physical Society.
Finished. You're finished.